friends, he who has health has hope. He who has hope has everything, we say. So this session is going to give you a lot of hope and it's going to be a very healthy session. So I can promise you that. Joining with me on this couch is a wonderful actress. She has wowed us with her performances on screen, be it down south, be it in Hindi, Rules, Pyar Ka, Superhit Formula, Tanmatra, many, many such superhit movies. Along with that, she continues to wow us with her fitness regimes. She looks super cool. So today she is here to share with us her health and fitness tips. It is with great joy that I welcome Meera Vasudevan to this wonderful chat.
Thank you so much, Meera.
Yes, so it's Meera and Meera.
Yes.
All right, so the weight loss story is truly interesting and I think it would be unfair if I do not ask you that right in the beginning.
Right.
How much did you lose? How long did it take? And how do you feel right now?
Okay, so I've got to say that 2014, I touched 97 when I was at the very height of my pregnancy.
Okay.
And then I got down to 64 kilos.
From 97?
Yeah, from 97 I got down to 64 kilos in 2016 end.
Yes, that's more than 30 kilos.
Yes, it is, it is. Okay. And my fitness secret has always been weight training, which is using resistance, using free weights,
right,
as well as through machines.
Right.
And it's something that I've enjoyed because fitness training is, I mean, weight training is something I've been doing since I was 19, 20 years old. Courtesy my mentor Milind Soman.
Okay, he is a supermodel himself.
Yes, yes. I mean, he was my first co-star for my Hindi film and he taught me the importance of staying fit.
Right.
Always. If you see how he is, how his mom is and all, it's simply astounding what, you know, how he has maintained himself and how he motivates and inspires others too.
Right.
So he's done the same for me. He made this huge change in my life. I have to say so.
So all credits to him.
All credits to him and to my hard work as well.
And of course to my coach.
Of course.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so how long do you take in a day for your workout and what is your routine? How long does it take?
See, the standard time that you need to give to a workout is 45 minutes. You don't really need more than 45 minutes per session. It's more than enough.
Per day?
Yeah. 45 minutes per day is more than enough, be it you know, cardio training, be it weight training, just 45 minutes per day is enough. And if you're just trying to maintain yourself, 3 days in a week is great. But if you're trying to lose weight, then I'm looking at 6 days in a week is fantastic.
You
take a day off.
You still take a day off. I mean,
yeah.
You could still take a day off.
Yeah. You need to take a day off because you need to give your body that kind of rest.
Right.
And you have to gradually build the intensity.
We shouldn't overdo it also.
Never. And your diet is extremely important because your diet is 80% of the whole process.
Right.
You know, your diet makes sure that you keep looking good, that you're having enough multivitamins, that you have enough nutrients in your body, you know, so that you don't have any kind of deficit, any
right.
problems.
Right.
You need to be strong.
Right.
You need to look good as well and you need to be fit.
Right.
And you can only work out well, you can only work out intense when you're eating right.
You have the energy to do that.
Yeah. I mean, I remember when I was younger, I used to eat like, you know, a few grapes, you know, maybe 2 or 3 slices of apples. And that was ridiculous. That was the worst thing to do.
Right.
Because
you're taxing your body.
Of course. And because of that, I developed medical issues like thyroid. I have hypothyroidism,
oh, okay.
which reduces the metabolic rate.
Right.
Which means I put on weight very easily.
Very easily, yes.
But I have maintained this weight since the last 1 year.
That's even after childbirth and
yes.
you will have enough of other responsibilities, but you still find time.
Yes, I do.
45 minutes a day.
I mean, workout is like the most important part of my personal routine.
Right.
That
you know,
way.
You know what? She's promised us that she's going to take us to the gym.
Yes.
So we are going to stick around with her for quite some time. We are all very eager to know that 45 minutes, what exactly do you do?
Yeah.
And you know, how does a routine go about? So do stay with us after the talk. It's not all talking. We are also going to, you know,
do
perform
some action.
Some action also coming up for you. And I have one more question for you. So after childbirth, of course, most of the ladies, they get a little, you know, little too held up with their own, you know, work and
yeah.
what made you decide that, no, I have to be fit? What was it because you had a, you know, one part of your mind said, I have to get back to the industry, I have to be back in shape? Or was it because, no, I just have to look fit? Which was it?
My thing was quite simple. My requirement was very easy. I want to keep pace with my kid. My kid is, he's very active.
Okay.
Okay. He's very healthy. He's very active. And I also made sure during my pregnancy that I had studied enough material to make myself undergo normal birth with no medication.
Right.
So my delivery actually just lasted 4 hours.
Oh.
Okay. That's it. Like a counted 4 hours with zero medication, zero epidurals, nothing. To make sure that my son is healthy. And I've managed to do that. By God's grace, I've managed to do that. Yes. You know? And post that also, the important thing is he's very healthy, he's very active. So if I am heavy, if I am hefty, then I can't manage housework. I can't manage, you know, taking care of myself. Then I can't take care of him either. Yeah. And being with a kid like him needs a lot of energy. I need to run around a lot him. If I'm slim, if I'm fit, I'm inspiring my kid also to do the same for himself, to invest in his own health. And I'm able to, you know, do all these activities with him. I can play with him, I can run behind him. And there's so many activities that I can do with him as a team. So that increases my bonding with him. That was my logic behind it.
Alright. Today, especially with too much of social media penetration, there's so much of body shaming happening. You know, either you make fun of someone because that person is too thin or too fat, and post-marriage, of course, everyone will put on weight. It's quite natural. So, did you have any situation where you faced such comments, and how did you get over it? Was there anything like that?
See, I have a very simple way of dealing with negativity. I just shut my ears. I really don't care. I really don't care a damn about such people, about negative people. I'm very clear about one thing. I keep only positive people around me.
But it's hard, no? Because when you step out, naturally there'll be people.
You know, in fact, it's that much easier. Because see, it's very easy to sense negative energy.
Yes.
It's very easy to sense negative energy. Anything that makes you uncomfortable.
Stay away.
Anything that makes you upset. Anything, any person, any situation that makes you feel uncomfortable or upset. Cut it out. It's that simple. Just be happy. It's like a promise you have to make to yourself that I'm going to be happy no matter what.
True.
You know? It's that way. Once you decide that way and then you keep making those changes in your thoughts, it just keeps going that way for you. It only keeps going positive.
Okay. It's the beginning that is hard.
Yeah.
Okay. So what have you got to tell these body shamers? Do you have anything to tell them? You know, who make comments about others' bodies?
Yeah, I do. It's just very simple. Get a life.
Start living yours.
Yeah.
So I like
focusing
that.
On other people's lives. Do something with your own.
I like that. Simple and straight. And
yeah.
Perfect. Okay. I think we would just, you know, take a walk outside, get some fresh air.
And then we will continue the segment there.
For a change, we have come out for a fresh breath of air, I should say. I was just thinking, you know, usually when you say 30, if you hit the 30s, most of them would say, oh, that's the, you know, expiry date for an actress. You know, at least in India, but of course it's changing right now. But once you are, you know, in your 30s, you are like, you won't be fit, you will be a mother by then, etc., all those things. But do you really think so? And one more question, who do you think, which actress do you think is looking fit and fabulous even in her 30s or 30s. Beyond?
You know, in 30s, your life just begins. Okay, 30s is like the best phase of my life. It has. I mean, it's at this time that I'm more relaxed, I'm more focused on myself, and I really, really am enjoying my life. It's like I've reached that point where I've realized that I've gone through so many experiences in life, and there is so much more that I have to offer personally, you know, to my relationships.
You grow wiser, I think.
Yeah, yeah, you do. You grow wiser, and you also grow a little more relaxed. It's like, you know, okay, I'm here, now what can I offer to people? That's what you feel like, you know, like you want to do so much more with your life and be happy.
So it's a myth, the 30 thing is a myth.
30 is where life starts.
Oh, come on, forget it.
You should be waiting to get to your 30s.
Right, so then the second part of the question, who do you think is, you know, perfect?
Bipasha Basu.
Okay, that's a wonderful choice.
Yeah, yeah, there's just no other options. Bipasha Basu is downright the best where it comes to fitness. I mean,
she releases videos and everything.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, she has been one of my inspirations too. Her slogan, love yourself, says a lot about the way women should take care of themselves and how women should handle themselves. I mean, look at this woman. She's like the perfect package.
I know.
She's lean. She's fit. I mean, she's mean. Mean in terms of the way she's maintained herself.
I know.
It's enviable. And it's inspiring all the same. She's so feminine. She's so graceful. She's so amazing. I just don't know any other word for it.
Words to describe.
Yeah.
I'm sure you're going to face similar issues right now because I have the pictures of a few of your co-stars and I have the first one for you.
Oh, wow. This is Jackie Shroff.
Jackie Shroff, yes.
Yes. So we worked together in a movie called Thodi Life, Thoda Magic.
Right. So is he a fitness freak or fitness enthusiast?
He is definitely, he believes in fitness as being one of the crucial parts of life rather than being the, you know, very center of life itself.
Okay.
Okay. And he's very relaxed, very chilled out. His whole approach to life is like, like a sort of meditation.
Okay.
He's very relaxed. Nothing can get him unnerved. Nothing can disturb him. He's like that. Very, very, very chilled out.
He looks rough and tough, you know.
He looks are very deceptive. He's very easy to communicate with and he's very easy to get along with. And it was a lot of fun. He made shooting a lot of fun.
That's interesting. And now I have someone else for you.
Oh, yes. Mohanlal sir.
Mohanlal sir, the pride, our pride.
Yes, he is a pride of Kerala.
He molds himself for every character.
Yes.
Do you know anything about his fitness regime?
You know, for Tanmatra, we had quite a tough time because the demand of the role was to keep putting on and putting off weight.
Okay.
Like in the beginning, I was 23 when I started shooting for Tanmatra. And the requirement was to put on 35
you had
kilos.
To look mature.
Yeah. I had to look like I were, 38 plus or 40 plus as a mother of two children. Back then when I had blonde hair and, I was only into jeans and tops and things like that, which I still do, only in different colors. But the thing is that this particular film was very demanding.
True.
And there was something I got to see about him, that this is a man who can brilliantly, take in all aspects. And put it into that role. Mm. That's how people relate to him.
His body listens to him.
He
puts on weight.
He's very flexible. He's very flexible in terms of the way he molds himself. Like if a role needs him to put on so much weight, he'll happily do it. Take it off, he's willing to do it. That's a kind of commitment. Yeah. It's an amazing sense of commitment. That's what makes him such a brilliant actor. Somebody that people can relate to very easily.
True. So now I have just one more of your co-stars.
Yeah, the brand ambassador of Pinkathon, Milind Soman. Yeah,
so
my mentor.
Tell me, your mentor, someone who inspired you to be what you are right now.
Yes, literally forced me into it.
So what's your take on Pinkathons and tell me about his fitness regimes and...
My take on Pinkathon would be that it's a brilliant initiative.
Are we ready to go?
And I think there can't be anybody better than Milind to endorse this, because the kind of charm he exudes and how good he is with people, and especially the women. Women just love him. They adore him.
I know.
When people talk to him, they're just floored by the way he is. He's such a nice guy to talk to relate to. He listens so well. So he just makes it, like he's able to... relate with people on such a level, get them involved into what he's doing. So I think when he's doing a cause like this for women, it just takes things up to a different level. So that's the great thing about him. And Milind was very crucial, very important for my getting into fitness, because in the time that we were shooting, I was not working out at all then. I was thin, of course.
Back when you were...
When I was 21. When I was 21.
Only
20. Yeah, when I debuted in Hindi.
Right.
So, the thing was, I was never into working out. And he asked me one day if I do and I said no. So, he just made it look like, we've got a shoot. And he grabbed me, took me out of my house. And he took me straight to his gym in Worli. And there, he got on the treadmill and he made me sit there, watch him. He got on the treadmill, he started with 11 kilometers per hour to warm up.
Mm.
He warmed up for a minute and then he just ran for 16 kilometers per hour continuously for an hour.
Non-stop.
He did not even stop to take a breath. He did not even stop to sip water. And I just kept watching there. I was so shocked.
Gaping.
Yeah. I was just standing there with my tongue literally hanging out. Thinking, oh my God, what is this? I've never seen this before.
I know.
I mean, this man is like the Terminator. This... Never ending, never stops for anything. He runs from his house to any meeting he has to go to.
Okay.
And he carries dumbbells in his car.
Okay.
So he can just literally have a workout anywhere.
Bottle,
he carries these dumbbells in his car with him. He can just stop anywhere and start a workout. Completely functional stuff. Like he would see something, he'll start off his workout. He's that cool. That amazing. It's like fitness is just... imbibed in his blood. It's in his blood, yeah.
Okay, so it's seeing him that is actually...
inspired me in a big way.
That you have to be conscious of your
fitness. It has.
Okay, so we are hoping to do something similar with our viewers right now.
Hope
so. We're going to, take, I think we are not taking her, she's taking us to her gym and she's going to work out. She's going to, take us through her fitness regime, and I'm sure at least a few of them, who are watching will definitely get inspired. Before that, I have just one question. What is your fitness goal?
My fitness goal is... Well, I want to work on my lean muscle mass percentage. I need to cut down on my body fat percentage some more. And I also want to get into martial arts in a way. I mean, I love MMA.
Wow.
Like some of my role models are Gina Carano and Ronda Rousey. So these are the kind of tough women that I really am inspired by. So I want to work at making myself really flexible, a little more aggressive and, fitter. better.
Okay.
Like, I want to be the best version of myself.
I'm picturing you on the silver screen doing the martial arts.
Some action? Yeah. So am I.
Alright, so I'm going to cut the talking. I've been doing that for quite some time now and it's time for some action.
Like, let's do that.
As you usually say. So let's hit the gym.
Yeah, let's stop talking and start doing.
Yes. Here we are.
Yes.
Meera ji is suggesting is it's okay to be enthusiastic, but do not get over enthusiastic and, you know, just jump into something without even realizing if that is the one suitable for your body.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and she was also telling about the warm-up thing, right?
Yeah.
So how does that work?
See, it's very essential to start your workout with a warm-up because obviously your body is not prepared.
Right.
And if you strain yourself in any way by taking up any kind of resistance, it's going to come on your back or come on your knees or your ankles, you know, or your elbows. Your shoulder joint. So it is very important that you warm up all these places,
right,
which help you move,
right,
and then you get on with it. And you start it with 5 minutes of walk on the cardio. Very simple walk just to get you slightly warmed up. You'll feel it.
Right.
Okay. Then you move on to doing free stretches and then you start your workout. That's how it's
so
done.
That's the proper workout.
Yes.
Treadmill doesn't count as workout.
Treadmill counts as a workout on alternate days when you're doing cardio.
Okay.
Although I am completely against running.
Okay.
I'm completely against running, to be very honest, because I have an issue with my left knee and all those things.
Okay.
That's the reason I'm against the running.
You know, these are some of the excuses that people come up with, you know. I have problem in my knees, I can't exercise, I can't do this, I can't
do that. I have problem in my knees, I have problem in my shoulder.
But then you find a solution to come out of it. That's not an issue at all.
Exactly.
You have other ways.
Exactly.
See, you have other ways.
Yeah, I mean, it's when I became overweight that these issues actually started.
Okay.
The knee, the left knee pain,
okay,
and the pain in my right shoulder and, you know, low BP, vertigo, and hypothyroidism. With all these things, I have managed to lose about 30 kilos. So I'm sure anybody can do
anybody
it if I can do it.
So I think now we'll
start
as such.
Let's start.
Okay,
let's start.
So
let's
all
start.
Yours, all yours. She's all pepped up.
Yeah.
I'm leading to you.
So whenever you get on the treadmill, one of the basic things is that you always keep your feet on the sides. You never stand on the belt and start. Okay? And it's very easy. There are a lot of buttons here. Don't get scared with anything. It's just very simple. Just press the start button. Then get on the belt and start moving. Start with your lowest speed so that you get comfortable on the treadmill and you can take your hands off and you can walk freely on it. You don't have to worry about the speed at which other people around you are running or walking. It's your speed that's most important and you should do it in a very, very relaxed manner. Then when you get a little used to the speed, slowly increase it. The important thing with doing any kind of training is to keep challenging yourself continuously. So you have to constantly keep rising and raising your own level also. So you walk at a comfortable pace for a continuous period of about 5 minutes. Okay, it helps you to get warmed up. And once you're done with that, this is very easy. Press the stop button and it stops. Now the normal way that I do my workout is a day of weight training and a day of cardio, and again a day of weight training, cardio, weight training, and cardio. Usually I also try to accommodate a couple of days of yoga in between that for muscle conditioning. It helps to de-stress, it helps to relax a bit. So we're going to start with some basic workouts. I'm going to run you through two variations of each muscle part. This is for the chest, also called as the pectorals. So Arun here, he's my trainer and he's going to help us today, help me to show you what we are doing. Hi Arun. Arun is a trainer with Goals and we are going to start our workout now. So that's a bench press. Alright, so this is something you call a pec fly. So I'm going to be flying. Elbow down. Right. As you can see, this works on your chest. So you exhale and come in, and when you're coming in, you come in fast and then you go back really slow. That's how you do any weight training workout. You always come in fast and then you go back really slow. Am I right, Arun? Thank you. So that's the pec fly. So this is something you call a lat pull down. Works on your back. Thank you, Arun. Alright, so you position yourself right, okay, soften your elbows and then you start. Whenever you pick up weights, you always do them in the way that they do not come on your back. And this is very important for women to know, because we women have a tendency of just lifting everything just like that, and that comes straight on your back. Instead, the best way to do it is lighten your load, bend, bend your knee, bend your back, and pick it up like a squat. That's the best way to lift a weight. Is that right? Okay, so what we do now is bent over rows. This also works for the back. Okay, you keep your knees soft, put your hip back, and you make your back parallel to the floor. Okay, your weight's here, and then you lift up. So this is what you call a bicep curl. How this works is you keep your knees soft again, keep your hip out, okay, your stomach tucked in, your shoulders dropped and your chest out. It's a very simple basic posture, right, and it helps to make sure that you're injury free and you focus on your bicep muscle. These are seated hammer curls. Again, these work on the biceps. What we call this is a tricep extension. This works on the tricep muscle. It makes your arms look much better. It's good to have good triceps, and it makes women's arms look a lot toned and really good. So here goes. This is a tricep extension. Again, the same posture, your knees soft, your hip out, your stomach tucked in, chest out, shoulder relaxed. And you have to extend completely. You have to open out your elbow and extend completely. Now here's what you call a tricep press down. Again, works on your triceps. Make sure arms look better. So here goes. Your hip out, stomach tucked in, shoulders relaxed, chest out, and your elbows should be near your body. Slightly raise up here, okay? Hold and press down. Now we'll move on to the legs. So this is what you call squats on the Smith machine. I've put some very basic weights, making it very easy. But the important thing is remembering the right posture and the right way of doing it. It has to come on your quadricep muscles in your legs. and nowhere else. Not on your back, not on your knees, not on your elbow or shoulder joints. Okay, it has to be done in the right way. It's best to do it with a trainer, very qualified trainer like Arun here with me. Let's start it. We call these the leg extensions. Again, these work on the quadricep muscles. Lock your legs behind this, toes pointed up, hands by the sides, holding this tight so that you don't move, you remain stuck in place. Let's start. Go to the next one. This is what you call calf raises. Works on your calves, makes your legs stronger, and also makes them look more beautiful when you're wearing dresses and shorts and all that. Let's do this. How it works with all of these is that we do 3 sets of each of these workouts and you do 15 repetitions. So that's one set of 15, second set of 15 and the third set of 15. So this way you complete all of these workouts, okay? And you can take the help of a good coach who will help you combine the right muscle groups so that you can do specific workouts on specific days and give yourself a rest of cardio on the alternate days. I think that's what makes a good, perfect, complete workout, and combine it with a diet and it makes a lot more sense. Now you start every workout with a warm up and you always end every workout with a cool down. So here are just some very basic simple stretches that you do to cool down. This is something for the calves, okay? And then you have for the quadriceps, push back as far as you can go and hold for 20 counts. And the same with this one. Then for your shoulders, your biceps, your triceps. Every muscle that you work has to have a counter stretch. It's very important so that you don't have a lactic acid buildup in your body, because that is what is going to prevent the stiffness, the very bad kind of stiffness that comes into your body. That shouldn't happen. You should still be able to do your work, you should still be able to run around, because as women there is so much that we have to do. We can't think about being stuck in the bed with all that body pain. Yeah, that body pain is also important because it helps to tear your muscle, and then your muscle becomes stronger and better. And the more the more your muscle builds, the more it eats away your fat and the more better it makes you look. Now, if you would say that, I don't get enough time, I have to take care of my kid, I have to take care of my family, I have to take care of my husband, I have to make the dabba for the day, I have to cook, I have to clean, I also have to do those things. But it's very important, I feel, that as women, we also, make the effort to take care of ourselves. Because in the long run, the only ones who will take care of us are us ourselves, and we all know that, don't we, Meera?
Yes, it's easy to just listen to the words, but it's very hard to believe that such things are happening when it's visually presented.
Yeah, and if I can do something like this, see, I have pain in my right shoulder, I have pain in my left knee, I have low BP, I have vertigo, and I also have a hypothyroid issue, which means that
enough of medical conditions to quote and say as excuse, no, I'm not good
exactly.
For exercising.
So the excuses are just a matter of how you think.
I know.
If you decide to do something for yourself,
nobody, nothing can stop you. Just get a good expert and just start going at it like I did.
Definitely, definitely. It was such a joy to see you talk about it and also to see you work out. And thank you so much. You're such
thank
a sport.
You.
I must definitely say. Friends, this is of course our fine actress Meera Vasudevan ji.
Thank you so much, Meera. This was a pleasure to discuss workout because cinema and workout are like my passions.
Definitely. So all the very best for both of your passions. Stay happy, stay healthy and stay fit as you always are. And that's the wish that we have for our viewers as well. Stay healthy and stay fit. Stay happy. This is goodbye from Meera Vasudevan
and
Meera Kasiraman. Bye-bye from the Meeras.